हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल फिस्क फाइनेंशियल स्टडीज क्लासेस। टुडेज सेशन इज अबाउट डिस्कसिंग हाउ हेज फंड स्ट्रेटजीज मे बी क्लासिफाइड। दिस इज द रीडिंग नंबर 26 एंड स्टडी सेशन 11 CFA लेवल 3 करिकुलम। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ हेज फंड स्ट्रेटजीज, वी आर गोइंग टू लुक एट the distinguishing features of hedge funds. As you can see here, there are a few features listed down. One of them is higher cost. As we all know, that cost of hedge funds is a bit on the higher side because of the active management involved and the complexity of the strategies. The second one is less transparency. The other one is liquidity constraint. As we know that most of the hedge fund strategies may require holding a position for a longer time and a lot of investments in illiquid securities, etc. That's why the liquidity constraints are higher on the hedge funds as compared to other channels like mutual funds or direct investment in equities or fixed income. The fourth one is larger investment universe. The investment horizon and investment universe of hedge funds is much higher, much larger than the equity and fixed income investors, because it involves commodities, currencies and derivatives, real estate, etc. Now, the fifth one is short selling is allowed in hedge funds, and you will find that even many strategies are completely based on short selling. We will discuss about that in a later videos. Other feature is uses of derivatives. The use of derivatives is very frequent in the hedge funds. After that, there is also a sort of very aggressive investing in the hedge funds. And the next one is uses of leverage. You will also find many strategies in the hedge funds which will have very high percentage of leverage involved. And the last one is the less legal and regulatory constraints in the hedge funds. Moving on, we will see the classification of hedge fund strategies. There could be more than this. The strategies classification is not limited to these six, but the curriculum provides us the information about these six strategies only. So we will focus on this one. First one is equity related strategy. In this strategy, the primary source of risk is equity risk. How it is different from the normal equity investment is that it is basically involves short selling frequently. Some of the strategies are dedicated short, in which they have most of the investment in short selling. Some are long short, in which they have long position as well as short positions. And there are some equity market neutral strategies, in which they will have positions in which the total market risk becomes zero and only the specific risk is where they are betting on. The second classification is event driven, in which the actions are based on some corporate events like merger, acquisition, bankruptcy, management or other change in management or any other big business event. The two event driven strategies which are being discussed in detail in the curriculum are merger arbitrage and distressed securities. In these two, merger arbitrage and distressed securities, we will discuss about them later, but as you can see by name, one is investing based on the expectation of any merger, whether it is going to go through or it will fail. The second one is investing on distressed securities in an expectation that it will bounce back. The third one is relative value strategy, in which the investor seeks profit based on the mismatch in the valuation of similar or same securities. The two specific relative value strategies which are taught in our curriculum are fixed income arbitrage and convertible bond arbitrage, which will be discussed later. Another classification is about opportunistic strategies. It focuses not on the value, but more on the major economic policies, major economics, macroeconomics. And based on that, they will assess what is going to happen in a particular market, and then they take the positions. So, as we can see, a coronavirus can be considered an opportunity for the people to short at a certain time and then long when the market is going to recover. So that is a kind of opportunistic strategy. Two subtypes which are going to be taught in our curriculum are global macro and managed futures. The specialist strategy is another classification of hedge fund strategies. It requires special expertise and knowledge, in which you have to be a very knowledgeable about some special factors, I would say. For example, like what happens in other positions, we take position based on the value, intrinsic value, and how it is different from the current market value. Whereas in specialist strategy like this, the people may take in a position in a particular factor like volatility or any other factor which they feel they know a lot about, and market is not actually capturing the value of that particular factor at that time. So that is one of the specialist strategy. Apart from that, there is also a strategy called reinsurance strategy, which comes under a specialist strategy. The last one is multi-manager strategy, which is not a new strategy at all. It is just a combination of all the previous strategies. So it means basically investing in all the strategies mentioned before. So there are two ways to invest in it. One is like going to a fund of funds, in which you invest in that fund and that fund will go and invest in each of these strategies individually. And there is another which is called multi-strategy fund, in which the same fund is investing in all these strategy based on their understanding of the market, and you just invest in that. So there are some pros and cons of both these strategies, how different and similar are these, which we are going to discuss in the future. For now, this is the amount of course we have in the LOS 1. So thank you for now. See you later.